Okay, one of the things I want to talk about when it comes to pulse width modulation or any system that actually runs a solenoid that opens and closes very quickly is the style of nozzles that we're going to run on it and our choices and how that operates in conjunction with that duty cycle or the speed at which this opens and closes. So when we open and close a solenoid very quickly, we have difficulty running things like air induction nozzles. You have to run specialist pre-orifice, a bit like your low drift types or standard flat fans on these. And you can see on this one, we actually have a model number. It's an 05 orifice. Now for most growers, you know, that might be running in the mid 20s, they might choose an 025 or an 03 nozzle. If I put an 05 on there, that means that the percentage of time this is going to be on, it's not going to be running continuously or 100% of the time. So if I'd normally run an 025 and I put an 05 orifice on there, it's going to be running about 50% of the time. And that's one of the issues that we find with these, is that if you put too big a nozzle on here, that duty cycle or the percentage of time that actually stays open gets too low. So nozzle selection becomes very critical. Now with this particular system, you can run Wilger nozzles, but you also have the option to buy retrofit caps and run T-jets on. But like any other system, you need to check that one, it's going to give the litres per hectare, two, it's going to give you the droplet size or spray quality you require. But the third thing you need to think about with these systems, and I can't emphasise it enough, is the percentage of time that's going to be on, or the duty cycle is absolutely critical. Now for a lot of in-crop sprays where you might be using a medium droplet, I would suggest to people to keep that duty cycle above 60%. So start as high as you possibly can. Don't let the machine slow down too much and the bottom end of 60, maybe 50%. But if you change to coarse droplets, they're not going to distribute around as much behind the machine. So you want to keep that duty cycle even higher. So typically I'd aim, again, start as close to 100% as I can, but in slowing down, try not to let it get below about 70% with a coarse. And so when you go around obstacles or the end of the field, think about how you plan the paddock, put a couple of headlands in, treat it a bit like other sprayers, but again, there's an added factor or duty cycle here which complicates things with pulse width modulation.